Alright guys, so today I am tying a deer spun head Zonker type fly. So this cone head is a size 6mm and the hook is a Gamagatsu SS15 and the size is size 2. So I'm going to go ahead and put on just for a little extra weight, and I want it more even instead of like a jigging action, so I'm going to put a little more weight on with this lead wrap. I'm going to put it towards the back of the fly here. And this thread is a very thick thread. This is Danville's Big Fly thread, I believe. And we are going to take a Zonker strip, and it's barred, and it's olive. So we're going to measure this to about the length of the hook. Make sure this is tied in right on top. And then we don't need it to go all the way to the top of the hook. I want to give a little extra there. So next I'm adding some gold crystal flash, and I'm taking 3 or 4 strands and then cutting it in half. We don't need the length, and that basically creates 6 strands. Tie it on one side and then the other. I have this really pretty black flashaboo. Again, 3 or 4 strands, I'm going to cut them in half. And this is kind of a Sculpin imitation. Sculpins have so many different colors, you know, to them. They're quite mottled, so that's why I'm adding so many different colors in this fly. Next, I have this Starburst dubbing. This is the golden peacock color, I believe. And we're just gonna do the normal pulling apart type thing to align the fibers. Set that aside. Once those are aligned, we're gonna go ahead and make a dubbing loop. And I have this high tack wax. Put a little bit on our thread. And that's just gonna help keep this fiber together, this dubbing right on there. Let me take our twister. We're gonna do just a quick little twist just to make sure that stays on there really good. And then I like having these short so I can put my finger right here and separate them. Make sure that this dubbing is aligned properly on here. Then you just pinch and twist. Spin together, you're basically making a hackle. And then you want to come in and pick out all the trapped dubbing. Now that that's picked out, we're going to take our toothbrush, comb that out. Wet your fingers and pull back everything so that way it's only on one side, and you want to pull it towards the back of the fly here, just like so. Just go ahead and start wrapping this up. You don't have to worry about making sure that it's palmered or anything. We're just basically creating almost like a dubbing ball right here. But you'll see the effect that it'll give. Again, we're just working to get multiple different colors on this. I like this to be a very flashy fly. It moves a lot of water and is really good for some big, big trout. Now we're going to pick out those fibers make sure they're all angled backwards. Next, I'm going to take some rubber legs, and we will tie them in right on the side of the fly. You don't have to worry about the length, we will trim that in a minute. Take two more, and we will tie them in on the other side. You really want to make sure those are, there's still bare shank here because we're going to be spinning deer hair. So let's turn the fly upside down here. And I like making a gill on these. You can use anything you want. But I've got this red calf tail. You want to take a very nice large clump of deer hair. Make sure with our fingers that we pull out a lot of the under fur, and we can comb out the under fur as well. Then we will stick that clump points down into our ear hair packer. Then we want this back end here square, okay? And the more, really, what's important I've found is more hair the better. So the larger clumps you get, you really want to pack this in tight. So you want these to be large clumps. So two loose wraps. Let's get that cone out of the way. And then we pull towards us. Allow that to spin around the hook shank. Again, like I said in that video, I'm not really that great at spinning deer hair. Pull as hard as you can with your specific tying thread. Now, I don't have GSB thread, so how hard I can pull is different than, you know, it's a little less. All right, so now that once that collar is made, it's kind of okay with it. It's a little patchy in spots, but that's okay, sort of. So now we're gonna go ahead and pack this in by using the cone head. So we just push, make sure that's scooted up the shank a bit, do a few wraps to secure that in there, and we are going to prepare one more section of deer hair. This time we don't need the tips though. So the same thing, two loose wraps, and we want to let this rotate around the hook, like so. And that is in there nice and tight. There we go. Alright, so we're going to make a couple wraps. It'll continue rotating, that's fine. Let's pack that in there nice and tight. A half hitch. I'm going to take some head cement here and apply a fairly liberal amount on my line. And then I'm going to do a couple half hitches. Pull that really tight. And let's go ahead and do one whip finish. All right, so there's the tying part. We're done with the tying part. Now we've got to trim this. What works really well is a razor blade. So one of these razor blades, it's a double-sided, and you can see that it's really easy to bend. Now, I am not very good at doing this on the vise, but I'm gonna give it a try. So what you wanna do is you wanna rest the end of the blade right on the cone head, and you wanna kinda angle upward a little. You kinda go back and forth a bit, and don't worry about the first couple cuts, we're just basically trying to remove a little bit to get to the, you know, start the shape basically. To have patience with this, you don't wanna just start cutting too much. Please keep in mind, I am no expert with this. There are people that are way better at this than me. Probably ones that you can find even on YouTube. So, you know, but hey, you can see really kind of how just the average guy does this, because I am average when it comes to this. Now this razor blade is giving me a little bit of trouble here. It's not super sharp, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of it. I'm going to grab myself a new one. Fresh and sharp. Hopefully this will, oh yeah, much better. And just do this a little at a time. It's going to take a little while to get it shaped where you want. You don't want to just make really big cuts and hurry on this. You want to really take your time. What this does though is it covers up a lot of your wraps, okay? And it also makes a very nice wide head that pushes a lot of water. So it's going to, you know, be a very good Sculpin imitation. So we're pretty close. You know, you can take it off the vise and play with it a little bit, but that's that. There's the fly. Now, I like, some people like to keep the full collar. I don't like this up near the hook. I feel like it might impede in hook set. So I like go ahead and basically I kind of make a flat bottom on this. You don't have to angle this as much. And I just, you don't have to, you know, make it as rounded and just kind of flat do it. And that will actually bring open the gill too, because the gill is hidden by that. So I will cut away, at least for this fly, the bottom here. Gotta make sure you're careful and not cut your other materials. I like trimming these up a bit. I don't want them as long. I just want enough so they come out and they move a little bit, add some, you know, a little extra movement. There we go. It also kind of makes it even wider, because these will stick out. You can see they stick out quite a bit. So that will give a little extra movement. So I'm gonna angle this back like this so I have room to work with. But I like taking this. Now you can either leave it this length, or you can cut it shorter if you want, however you want to do it. I like leaving it kind of long, but I like cutting a kind of like a taper into the back here, and what that will do is that will add to the taper of the tail. And also, a more tapered tail will allow this to move a lot more free in the water. This will end up being a little more movement. It'll kind of, the way that the current will hit the front will also wiggle this